Are you going to Scholar Affair? Parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme. Remember me to the one who lives there. He was once a true love of mine.
Are you going to Scarborough Fair?
Stay by my side when I
Thank you. Grant, I wonder if you could just put up the guitars a bit in the monitor. I'd be very happy. Thanks. Well, my name is Andre Hatting, for you that don't know me. And this is my sister, Jenny. And we've been singing together since we were born. And we actually grew up in a little town, not very far from here, called Ladysmith. And it is quite a roaring metropolis, Ladysmith is. And for those of you who know it, know that nothing ever happens in Ladysmith.
Except the siege.
Siege. And then a few years later, there was the Hatting sisters. At 13 and 15 years old, we were singing in a coffee bar, and an impresario spotted us, and he offered us the most marvelous job. He said, "Would you like to be the supporting act to Groep Twee?"
You guys remember them? Sias Reineke and Gert van Bommel.
We went all over South Africa as these little Hatting sisters, and this is one of their songs.
Jy met wandelingie, ek met wandelingie, sing ons die okraliekie saam. Sing ons van waterstrome, slange en olien op oorlippe, waar daar teen die ruitie staan. Ons
almost 50 years later, we've picked up our guitars again, and we're singing the same wonderful songs we sang as teenagers.
Well, you would have recognized the opening number. I'm sure a lot of you hippie-come-home guitarists all sang Scarborough Fair. And of course it was made famous by Simon Garfunkel, I think. They really got it going. And then, of course, we had the Seekers. Boy, did Andre and I love the Seekers. I think it's because she sings like Judith Durham. And a bit better too. And apparently they, the Seekers, have just completed their 50th anniversary tour.
Copycats.
Absolutely. Do anything there. People don't copy you, no?
But this next number you're going to have to sing along with.
Yes.
So you better prepare your vocal cords.
Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountain, Shenandoah River. Life is over there, older than the trees, younger.
Virginia, mountain mama, Deutschendorf. You know how he changed his name was when he was at his first concert. His impresario came up to him and said to him,
"Listen here, Jonah boy, your name just don't fit on the billboard. And you're going to have to change it." And poor John thought, "What am I going to call myself?"
And then he remembered that he was singing the concert in Denver, so that's how he got his name, John Denver.
Imagine if I suddenly become Jenny Hilton.
Well, it sounds like
not terrible. Roberta Flack is somebody you all remember. Well, I bet you didn't know that she was in fact a very famous concert pianist. Do you know that? She was a fantastic pianist and she won a bursary to a university to study her music further. And whilst she was there, she discovered another instrument, her voice. So this is one of our favorites.
I felt a flush with fever.
wonderful audience, now we're going to give you some more work to do, is to remember these songs. You know, songwriters, they're inspired by all sorts of things to write songs, but I think the thing that they're most inspired by is falling in love, having a problem with love, and then breaking up. So we've decided to put together three songs from the 60s, and they tell that story perfectly.
Well, the first time I heard Dream a Little Dream of Me, it was sung by the Mamas and the Papas. And I thought, wow, what a voice Mama Cass can sing. Anyway, I thought they'd written the song. But in fact, after a bit of research and looking in history books, etc., we discovered the song was written long before any of you were born. It was written in the 1930s. And was performed by all the great songers of that time.
Yes.
Singers, sorry, not songers. Singers of songers.
Yes. Like Ella Fitzgerald and Louis Armstrong.
Thank you very much. Anyway, I'm neither of those. Here goes. Oops. Tight? That's fine.
Do the title song of our show. Our show is called Forever Young. Isn't that a nice name? And of course, that song was written by the wonderful poet of the times, Bob Dylan, and it was made famous by his gorgeous lover, Joan Baez. So we're going to sing Forever Young, and listen carefully because the words are special for you.
Thank you. surrounding you.
May you always be courageous, stand upright and be strong. May you stay.
Left the United States of America, and it has arrived
at Jan Smuts Lughawe, South Africa, 1960 voetsek. En ons gaan weer nou 'n paar Suid-Afrikaanse liedjies sing, en julle gaan elke een herken. Jy sal onthou met wie julle was, wat julle gedoen het.
Wie gevry het, Chikilei? Wie die ander hy, Chikilei?
Die gezin van die berg.
Ja, en toen was het Master Jack. What do you know? Yes, Paul Jackson and Joel. Someone got 10 out of 10 there. And who was the writer? David Marks. He was a miner, a gold miner, in the Free State, and wrote this amazing song, which became a huge hit. Apparently, it's the biggest hit to have ever come out of South Africa. Can you believe that? It was top of the hits in Canada, USA, England, Rhodesia in those days. South Africa, obviously. And the most amazing thing about that song, Andre and I haven't got a clue what it's about. So if any of you can tell us what the ribbons are, what we should be doing with them, come and tell me afterwards. I could even perhaps buy you a cappuccino. As a young girl, I knew exactly who I wanted to sing it to. But to this day, we're trying to work out who did she actually write it to or about.
Yeah, it could have been Warren Beatty, because he's seriously vain. And but I don't think James Taylor.
No, I don't think so. Mick Jagger has also been apparently. Sniffing around. Thanks, whatever. Been mentioned is the word I wanted to say. That's right. So we could still ask him, and I think he's so vain he wouldn't admit to it.
Yeah.
Our next featured artist is Joni Mitchell, and she's somebody who discovered very early on in her life that she was musical. When she was about 9 years old, she contracted polio, and she had to be in hospital for many, many months. And then she discovered that she could entertain the patients. And she also admits that at 9 years old, she started her lifelong addiction to smoking.
Wow.
She was a really wild child, and at 17, she ran away from home to become a folk singer. And soon she found herself barefoot and pregnant, and nobody to look after her or the child. And so she had to give the child away. And she says that this was one of the biggest, the most incredible turning points in her life. And many of the songs that she's written are attempts to reach this little girl that she gave away.
Mike's moving off.
Oh, hello.
Yes. Hello, you're back.
Yes, I think so.
Well, fortunately, there's quite a sweet ending or lovely ending to that, because she was reunited with her daughter in the 90s. So they did find each other.
We're going to sing our favourite song of Joni Mitchell's called Both Sides Now.
Can you make a tiny bit? Are you there, Mr. Grant? Never mind. We're going to sing you a song now by Janice Ian. Guess what about her? She's exactly my age.
Yes, and exactly as beautiful.
Oh, never.
And talented. And marvelous. She was born to a very musical family. And at the age of 13, Janice Ian could play the piano, the harpsichord, the guitar, the French horn, the flute, the...
What else?
She could play an enormous amount of instruments. And she also, at 13, had her own first big hit called Society's Child. What a start.
But then she is now a science fiction writer. And still regularly performs live.
Yes.
So she's quite a girl. This is one of our favorites. It's called The Other Side of the Sun. Okay. Foxy, different place. One, two, three, four.
Bet you in the morning you won't even know I'm gone. Tired of living here in the middle of a mixed emotion. Might as well be living on the other side of the sun.
Phillips of the Mamas and Papas was staying in a freezing cold New York one winter. A bit colder than here. It's hard to believe. He went for a walk this one early Sunday morning. He thought, let me get out of this hotel. And he went for this lovely walk through a park. And he passed a little chapel and a churchyard and people and dogs and aunties and grannies. And when he got back to his room, he thought, what am I doing in this freezing place? I'm a Californian. I don't like it here, it's too cold. And that is where California Dreamin' was born, right there. One, two, three, four. To dedicate to a very dear friend of ours, whom I see sitting in the front row, Roger Shepherd.
Hey!
He's always telling us to sing this song, so we just banked it as a surprise for him.
Some of you may remember it as a Roy Orbison number, because Roy Orbison wrote the song. And some of you may remember it as a Linda Ronstadt song, because she made it famous in the 70s.
Lynn. By you.
Happy times on Blue Bayou. I'm going
you. Well, we'll have to take some special requests with all this wonderful response. We're going to sing you a song now that it's nearly home time, so we're going to sing you a song called Homeward Bound. Of course, another Simon Garfunkel number. And you know, when these two guys were at school together, they started a band. And guess what they called themselves?
This is definitely a coffee, if you know the answer.
Tom and Jerry.
Well, it's nearly as bad as the Duke sisters.
Okay, chaps are just having a little break while we tune.
Was it the guitar warm geslaan?
A time of war, to fight with words.
of protest,
drugs,
assassinations, Woodstock, Kennedy, and King. It was a time of poets and songs, voices of the youth, a time of love, a time of hope, a time of peace. And I was at Epworth. Maritzburg brings us, so we come back to our roots.
I loved you in the morning. Behind standing in Thank you.